Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to install VMware Player on Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to install the free version of VMware on Windows, you can follow these steps. And the first thing you need to do is open up your browser of choice and then do a Google search for a VMware Player. If you do that Google search, you should get this result that says a VMware workstation player. You can click on that. And then on this page, you'll find this download for free button. You can click on that. On this next page, you'll find this product downloads tab here. And then you can click on go to downloads. And then on this next page, you can either download it for Linux or Windows, but we want to download it for Windows. So we'll click on the download now button. That's for the VMware player for Windows. It's close to 600 megs in size, so it might take some time to download depending on your internet speed. Once it's finished, you can just click on the file to open it. It's going to start the installation for VMware workstation player. At this point, you can close your browser. You'll get this prompt that you need to restart your computer. You can click yes if you want to restart now, or no if you first need to save some of your work and then manually restart later. For this guide, I'm just going to click on yes to restart now. So once your computer has restarted, just navigate back to your downloads folder and then run the VMware player installation file again. Now you should get to the VMware setup wizard. You can go ahead and click on next. You can click on this checkbox to accept the terms, then click on next again. Here you'll have these two options to add an enhanced keyboard driver, and you'll also need to reboot your computer again. I recommend that you enable this and that you also enable the second option to add the VMware console tools into your system path. So select both of these, then click on next. Leave this option checked to check for product updates on startup, but you can choose if you want to join this VMware improvement program. I'm going to deselect this because I'm not interested in that. Then you can just click on next. And then you can choose to create shortcuts in your desktop or start menu folder. I'll just leave both of these checked and then click on next and then click on install. And that's going to install VMware to the computer. Once the setup is completed, you'll see this window. And if you have a license for VMware, you can click on license and then enter the license key. But we're only interested in using the free version, so you can go ahead and click on finish. And then you might be prompted that you need to restart again, and you'll need to go ahead and click on yes. Once your computer has restarted, you should now have this VMware icon on your desktop. You can go ahead and double click on that to launch it. Once again, if you have a license key, you can enter it here. But if you only want to use VMware for free and non-commercial use, you can just leave it on this option, then click on continue. Then you can click on finish. And then it'll launch the VMware workstation player on your computer. Now you can go through these options to create a new virtual machine or to open an existing virtual machine. That's not going to be part of this guide. This video's intention is only to show you how to install VMware to your computer on Windows. So I hope this guide's been useful. If you have any questions or thoughts on the video, please leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to like the video, and I'll see you in the next one.